Welcome to CVTV. I'm Lexi.
And I'm Kara. CVTV is a brand new program here at the Intermediate School.
Today, our first show begins with an interview with our principal, Mrs. Fields.
Thanks, Lexi. I'm Sam. Karen and I are here with Mrs. Fields.
What are some of the best things about the Intermediate School?
There are two really wonderful things about our school. First of all is our staff. Our teachers and the people that work in our school are just wonderful. They really work hard to help kids. They really work hard to do everything we ask them. They're caring. They take care of things in the community. And the second best thing are you kids. The best thing about coming to work every day is knowing that I get to see about 760 different kids a day and get to know what they're doing and get to learn about the things that they like and get to see what they're learning, get to see their projects. And that is the absolute best thing about CV.
Well, what do you think about the CVTV show?
I'm so excited about the TV show. I think this is just a wonderful learning opportunity. Not only is it really cool for you guys to get to be on camera and get to edit film and get to shoot film, but it's really nice that all of the parents and all of the people in the community are going to get to know our school and see things that we can do and that we've got kids that can do wonderful, tremendous, awesome things.
What are your plans for the holiday break?
There's a couple things I have planned. I've got about four books that I have on a shelf that I haven't started reading yet, so I'm going to finish those four books before I come back. I have my family's coming home, so I have two daughters and two granddaughters, and they have husbands and that kind of things, and they're going to be coming to my house. So I'll be doing a lot of cooking and a lot of baking and a lot of crafts because my granddaughters like to sew and do crafts and things. And then when they go to bed, I'll get my book out.
Thank you, Mrs. Fields. Now let's go back to the studio.
Thank you.
Thank you, Karen and Sam, for that wonderful interview. Thank you to everyone who donated to the photo drive. The intermediate school students did a great job donating food. Your support is appreciated. And thank you to all the students who wrote letters and contributed to the intermediate school's troop appreciation effort. The troops and families thank you. Our next segment of the show is today's question of the day. Listen carefully to the question. If you have an answer, write it down on your CVTV slip. Questions of the day will be put on Mr. Wilson's desk. The answer slips can be placed in the CVTV Question of the Day box by Mr. Wilson's desk. One correct answer will be drawn, and a winner will be picked by the end of the next day. Ready? Here's the question. What four bordering states make up the area known as Four Corners, USA? What four bordering states make up the area known as Four Corners, USA? Good luck. Let's go to an interview with Mr. Huber.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm here with Mr. Huber. Could you please tell us a little bit about the new anti-bullying system?
Sure. Our new anti-bullying program is called OVEAS, and OVEAS is pretty much meant to help reduce bullying situations and help empower the bystander, make the bystander become involved. There's a couple things that we're doing with it. We do have weekly class meetings with every classroom having a little meeting with our group. We talk about different topics, about bullying, different types of respect, how to treat other people, things like that. We also have weekly cult heroes, where there's one from each grade level, and pretty much we're trying to look for students who exemplify or really show the characteristics of being a good student, not bullying other students, treating people with respect, being kind, caring, and considerate. We have all of our teachers trained on this program, all of our lunch monitors, bus drivers, and everybody else. So everybody can work together here to help make the school a very happy and safe place for students.
What are your plans for the holiday?
My plans for the holiday? Well, I'm going to be spending a lot of time with my family. My brother and his wife and my baby nephew are coming up from Atlanta to spend a week up here. So I'll get a week with my 10-month-old nephew, which I'm really looking forward to. And a lot of time relaxing and enjoying my vacation. So it'll be a good little break, and looking forward to coming back in 2012 to all the wonderful students here and having a great second half of the year.
Thanks, Mr. Hubert. Let's go back to the studio.
And now for the weather this week.
Thanks, Lexi. This week's weather features colder temperatures with a chance of snow. There will be snowstorms in the Rocky Mountains. In Pittsburgh, we can expect temperatures in the 30s and a chance of snow from Thursday through Sunday. Don't forget to zip up your coats.
Well, it's December and a time for traditional holidays. This month we celebrate Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, and Christmas. Let's go to the field to hear what holiday plans some folks have.
We're here with the art teacher, Ms. Mastrine Williams. What are your plans for the holidays?
Well, my plans, I'm going to spend the day with my children. I have two young children, Olivia and Jonah. They're 4 and 2 and a half. And I'm going to make a big dinner, and all of my brothers and sisters are coming over for dinner.
I'm Lydia, and I'm here with Mr. Wilson, our campus security officer. Mr. Wilson, what are your plans for the holiday?
Well, I plan to spend time with my son. I may travel to New London, Connecticut, and Groton, Connecticut to see my sisters. But to enjoy the holidays with my son, Roderick Wilson, Jr., I think that would be the highlight of my holiday time off.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mrs. Valerio. I want to wish everybody a great holiday season. Spend some time with your loved ones and be nice to your family this holiday. And have some well-deserved rest. And remember, do something nice for someone this week.
I'm Brian, and I'm here with Miss Newman. What are your plans for the holiday?
Well, Brian, I celebrate Hanukkah with my family, and we have Luckies, which are potato pancakes, and we light the candles every night. We light what's called a menorah, and we also exchange gifts. Some people celebrate Hanukkah for 8 nights, and they actually give a gift each night. My family doesn't. We kind of just do it on one night. We give all the gifts. Kind of like Christmas, but it's a lot of fun.
Thank you. Let's go back to the studio.
Thanks.
And now we have a clip from third grade presentation of Christmas Around the World.
Benvenuto Sweet Italia. Welcome to Italy.
Our country is Italy. Our country is bordered by, on the north, Liechtenstein, the south, Tunisia, on the east, Slovenia, and on the west, France. My country is in the shape of a boot. This is the Leaning Tower of Pisa. It is 117 years old. This is the outside of the Colosseum. This is also the inside. It is where the gladiators fought. This is the Vince Canroll. Did you know some of their roads are water?
Four famous sites to visit in Italy are the Leaning Tower of Pisa, Colosseum, Vatican City, and the Trevi Fountain. Leaning Tower of Pisa. The Leaning Tower of Pisa is a freestanding bell tower. The height of the tower is 183.27 feet from the ground on the low side and 186.2 feet from the ground on the high side. Vatican City is the smallest country in the world with the smallest population. Italians are allowed to donate 8% of their yearly taxes to Vatican City instead of paying the Italian government. Vatican City's radio station is located in a town inside Vatican City's gardens and broadcast in 20 languages throughout the world.
These were some of the famous sites I talked about. Me and my dad made a poster last night, and that's what we came up with. Christmas traditions. Vina, Bufana, and Nativity Scene. Novena begins 8 days before Christmas. They get together and say a bunch of prayers.
Bifana. Bifana fills candy in your shoes if you are good. This is a purse that was made in Italy. And this is a glass bracelet that my aunt got me when she traveled to Italy. Capitone is roasted veal served on Christmas Eve. This started in a little fishing town in Italy. Minestrone is an Italian soup, also called the big soup because it has so many ingredients. It contains onions, carrots, beans, tomatoes, and pasta. Cannoli is a dessert from Sicily, Italy. It has a sweet, creamy filling. Gelato is the Italian word for ice cream. It is homemade and has less fat than ice cream we buy at the store. This is a pencil maker, and it's like a flat cookie, but like it has the pattern of usually a flower in it, and some people usually eat it for breakfast.
CV has some great musicians, so to close out our program today, string students will play a holiday favorite. CVTV today. We'll see you next time.
Happy holidays!
Happy holidays.